We were national champions in 65 and 66. In the years that we played, we could not play any school in the South. We could only play the Big Ten schools and some of the teams out West.
Racism in the 1960s and today is not a Southern problem. It's an American problem, and Daugherty feels the effects of it.
Dad was looking at starting a black quarterback, Jimmy Ray, and that would be the first time in Michigan State's history. This supposed friend of my dad said, "You know, Duffy, the day that you start a black quarterback at Michigan State, we will no longer be friends."
A film about football and so much more. Through the Banks of the Red Cedar tells the story of former NFL athletes Gene Washington and Bubba Smith, who were recruited to play college football at the peak of segregation here in the U.S. during the 1960s. The film is set to make its local premiere tonight. And joining us this morning is filmmaker Maya Washington and her father, Gene Washington. Good morning and thanks for being here.
Well, good morning.
I'm so very honored to have you in our presence.
Thank you. We're honored to be here.
Wow. Yes, yes. Okay, Maya, what is Through the Banks of the Red Cedar all about?
Well, it really follows my dad's journey from segregation to Michigan State at the peak of the civil rights movement. He was raised in LaPorte, but wasn't able to attend high school in LaPorte because of segregation and was bused to George Washington Carver in Baytown. So he and Bubba Smith were great friends, and Bubba Smith's family is really the reason my dad got to Michigan State. So we look at that whole connection to the Houston area.
You could have kept this story within the family. Why did you want to share it with the world?
Well, I think it's really important that our generation understand what my dad's generation did to provide opportunities for athletes, but for African Americans and people of color in a variety of fields.
Gene, what was it like playing football back in the 60s?
Well, it was very, very exciting. And it was more than just a football. I had an opportunity from an education standpoint to go to Michigan State University when I could not go to the University of Texas and Rice and those universities. So it meant much more from an educational sense.
But what about the discrimination that I know you felt during the 60s?
Well, we were primarily in the 60s, we were primarily at East Lansing in Michigan State, but going up there before, the discrimination, it was there, you know, in terms of the restroom facilities, the hotel facilities, and we were not allowed to vote and all of those things. I was brought up in that, so it was great to have a chance to leave that segregated situation and go north to an integrated situation.
What influence do you think you and your teammates had on the game itself in transforming it into what it is today?
I think that being a part of the first fully integrated championship, see, I was very fortunate to be a part of two undefeated national championship teams, and that also two undefeated Big Ten teams. So that was a lasting impact, and so when almost half of your team happened to be African Americans, that was a huge first, and with a black quarterback. And at the time, for years and years, that was unheard of, to have a black quarterback. And most importantly, all of my teammates, I would say the majority of my black teammates, we were all from the South. And we were recruited by Duffy Daugherty, our football coach, mainly because he put on all kinds of coaching clinics down here in the South. For example, coaches from Prairie View and coaches from Texas Southern, and then all of the black high schools here in the Houston area. And so he was well known throughout the South, and he did a tremendous job of recruiting us to go to Michigan State.
Wow. Okay, now, where is the film with this magnificent story going to be showing?
So tonight, Showbiz Cinemas, Baytown, mm-hmm. and there's still some tickets available, so people can get them online at eventbrite.com, and we're just so excited to share it with the local community.
Well, we're so glad that you decided to come in to share it with us so we can share it with our viewers. Gene, thank you so very much, Maya, and I appreciate your efforts in putting a film together about Papa.
Thank you.
Thank you.